part of our marketing campaign is going to places. One of the things as a private school that we have a very strong relationship is the foster community. And so a lot of our students coming in the private school were actually foster students or foster children. And so we will continue that as well as homeless children. One of the things that we recognize is that our student body will reflect where we go. And you know, that's the biggest draw versus, like you said, students or parents that actually come to you. And so, you know, we have a very determined drive for the types of students that we want. First of all, it would be the West Charlotte community, and then the homeless and foster children, and then different churches that are just located throughout West Charlotte, because again, that's our primary draw because that's where we're located. Transportation will have cluster stops. We won't do buses, but we'll have cluster stops. So cluster stops are, you know, it might be the Walmart on, what's that road, Brookshire or somewhere over there. And so that would be a cluster stop. So parents would have to get them to the cluster stop, and then the van or the bus would drive them to school versus doing the neighborhood stops that CMS does. And so that's our transportation plan. And then we have a very strong carpool. Our parents are great with carpooling, and the PTO actually sets up our carpool locations. And then, you know, there's a certain protocol to be part of carpool, whether you're helping with transportation or you're not helping with transportation, to cover costs for gas and things like that for parents. Does that answer all your questions?
Okay.
Free and reduced lunch.
Who actually leaves your school?
Leaves? Oh, free and reduced lunch, definitely. Again, you know, we talked about the meals, having healthy meals and having breakfast and lunch served. Snacks are also available throughout the school because we recognize not all of our students are going to get three meals a day. And as a private school, our retention was related to tuition. As a charter school, our goal is to have 98% retention, where the only students leaving are because they're moved outside of our area. That's been our experience as a private school. Once you have experienced Student First Academy, like the gentleman said, you kind of want to go there yourself now at this age. There's nothing like it. There's nothing like it.
The meeting that he had with all the leaders, and we spoke directly to him coming over to Student First, and so he said that he would be anxious to do that. So that is definitely him and a couple of the other people that actually work with him. We've worked with some of the CMS schools in the past, and so it really is a goal to, you know, just bring all those educational entities together. It's all about the children. First of all, the sustaining part is really financially is just about over, because as a charter school, our budget is set up so that the only funds we actually would be using, along with a contingency fund built in there, is the funds that we get from the federal government. So all of our grant dollars and any other fundraising dollars and donations will be extra money that will be used for our students. In the past, over the last 10 years, we have the history. We show that we've been able to sustain with income-based tuition. So we're right there. I mean, as soon as our charter year starts, it is all about opening the doors to academic wonderland that's being funded by the government.
Oral presentation is very important to our school. Because we do seminars and we are constantly helping our children understand that in order to get your best point across, you have to be able to pursue a lot of different avenues, which not just communication and verbally, but your body language as well. And so presentation for us would be at the very top of the core of everything that we do. So each of our classrooms are designed that they have presentations they have to do on a monthly basis. And then we do weekly seminars as well. So drama and presentation is a big part of that. Our students, like I said, have to write and produce their own play. And that they submit a lot of them, and then they read them, and then they vote on which one is chosen for that one presentation that we'll do school-wide. So it is very, very important presentation skills. You know, in order for somebody to truly understand what you want to say, you have to be able to say it in a manner that everybody understands.
Okay.
and we definitely plan to partner. We've already initiated dialogue with some of the other charter schools, and we've partnered up with private schools, and we also have partnered up with CMS in the past for their, what is it, Queen City Competition. We were the only private slash charter slash non-public school in there for several years. So our goal is, again, it's all about children. So every entity that's out there, whether it's public, private, charter, after school, anything, we're going to work with them.